That's Doug Smith, the Toronto Star. I mean, your team has fought back a lot all year, but it's the holes you put yourselves in that is more problematic. Is it all right?
No question. I just thought the second quarter is when they ramped up the pressure. Had six turnovers, which was huge. And the difference in this game is the turnovers. We got to meet their physicality. We got to understand how the officials are calling the game and play accordingly. I just thought that 19 turnovers, a lot of those was getting knocked off our mark, and we just got to be strong with the ball. Or, accordingly, turn around and play the way they're playing, bumping and hitting in those situations. So, things that are correctable, but I love the fight for my team, Doug. This team tried to throw haymakers at us and go at us, and we did a good job. We did a good job of battling back and staying in the game and staying competing.
Cole Kelly, the Globe and Mail. Dwayne, back here. I know that you'd like to joke that you don't want to give away any of your money, but when you saw that Vasquez foul at the end and then the technical, what was going through your mind?
Again, I like my money. But again, we've got to go back. I got to go back and look at the tape. And, you know, those kind of calls, you know, broke our back. It was a difference in the game. You know, again, they're a great team. We give them credit. We respect them. But let's let the game be dictated by that. I got to go back and look at it and see what the calls were. You know, I had a different view of them, evidently, as those guys did.
Eric, we'll see. Sorry. Eric Curry, National Post. Terrence didn't get back into the game after the first 5 minutes. What did you see from him, and what did he need to do?
He just struggled getting, you know, he had three turnovers. Believe me, this had nothing to do with Terrence Ross at all. He played the way I figured he was going to play. They got into him. He just struggled getting off his mark. I just thought John and Landry gave us more physicality at that position. Believe me, Landry's going to be okay. I mean, Terrence is going to be okay.
Dwayne, Chris Mannix, Sports Illustrated. The two losses this series, you've had problems with Darren and Joe, keeping them under wraps. What kind of problems are they causing for you guys so far?
One-on-one. That's the difference, Chris. We've got to do a better job of making sure we get help there quicker. When we do get it there, we're in pretty good shape in those situations. So we got to make sure we recognize where they are on the floor and how they get them. They're two great one-on-one players. And there's no one guy on our team is going to guard them by themselves. So we got to make sure we get help there.
Dwayne, Fred Kerber, New York Post. Larry seemed to be limping a lot. What's his status and how hurt
is he? He banged knees. I mean, he got a sore knee, got a big knock on his knee. Bit not on his elbow, busted nose, busted lip. So he's been in a 15-round bout, but he's going to be okay.
Coach Steve Simmons, Toronto Sun. How hard is it to assess a game like that when from about 2 minutes to go in the half, you seem to be completely out of it, and then you're two free throws away from tying it with 16 seconds to go?
It's unbelievable, but I love our resolve. That's one thing about this young team. They never give up. They never give in. They fight through everything. You know, they had some tough calls down the stretch. They could have mailed it in, and they didn't, Steve. And that's what I love about our team.
Dwayne, Mike Grange from Sportsnet. Before the game, you were wondering, how would these guys respond? First game on the road, and the line's down. I don't know if it was one, but what did you think of your group?
I thought it was solid, except the second quarter. I thought they imposed their will on us in the second quarter and did a good job of bringing the physicality. I thought we turned it around in the fourth quarter and met it. But like Doug said, we can't wait till the fourth quarter to meet the physicality and adjust to the way the officials are calling the game in the fourth quarter. If the officials are allowing the physical play, we've got to play that way. So that's the difference in the game. We've got to do that.
Dwayne, Ryan Wolstad, Toronto Sun. Before and after the trade, the team's gotten into some trouble when it goes to the ISO ball, and that sort of happened in the third as well. How much of the offense was by design isolation, and how much was what they were giving?
A lot of it was what they were doing, Ryan, switching. Got us in those situations. We've got to make quicker decisions. I thought we took advantage of it a few times, but too many times we got stagnant by not moving the ball, and that's something we got to do a better job with in coming the next game. The key thing is moving the ball without turning it over. That's the whole key. You know, they got 16 points on 19 turnovers. Everything else, you look at the stat sheet, it's all the same. We got to do a better job in a one-on-one defense with Joe Johnson and Paul Pierce and Darren Williams. But with that said, if we take care of the ball and be strong with the ball and make the easy plays, that's the difference, as it was in game one and two.
Dwayne, Devin Carpadian from the Brooklyn game. You guys use Patrick Patterson for a lot. He I think hit 3 or 4 3-pointers. He's kind of. Do you see him as a counter to the way the Nets play with their stretch four and, you know, small ball?
Patrick brings so much to the table. His physicality, his intensity. He can knock down shots, and we needed that tonight. We needed to be able to stretch the floor out because they are playing small. That small ball gives them a little bit of an advantage, but with Patrick. One thing it does is allowed us to really crash the boards, and that's where I think we have an advantage. But he's playing excellent. He's kind of getting back the rust off after the injury he had. He's playing a lot better.
Dwayne, as well as Patrick played, what do you say to him when he had 2 shots to tie it and couldn't deliver?
That's part of the game. You know, he got himself in that position, and, you know, he missed the shots. That happens. You know, you got to live with it. Again, there's nothing in this game that discourages me from our team. I love them. They compete at every turn. Every time you think they're down and out, they keep coming back, keep coming back. We just got to get some more productivity out of one more position in this series.
Dwayne, DJ Sixsmith, WFUV Radio. You have a very young team. Obviously, it didn't go the way you wanted to today. So what's the most important lesson you can instill for the guys going into next game?
Well, like I said before the game, next play. You know, whatever happens, whether it's you lose the ball, you miss a shot, you miss a free throw, you got to come back and play the next play. And that's what they're doing. Again, be sharper in our rotations defensively. Make sure that we take care of the ball. Get away from so much ISOs. But again, the way they're playing us causes that a little bit. And you got to tip our hat to them. But now we've got to make some adjustments to get away from just the one-on-one trying to attack one against four.
Final question to Josh.
Josh Lewenberg, TSN Radio. Coach, you talked about using the tight rotation after game two. How much was it matchups tonight, foul trouble that kind of took you out of that?
Well, the thing about it, just searching. We were searching for that next guy. T-Raw struggled a little bit, so we were trying to get a next guy. Another one, just trying to get someone, make sure we had a matchup for Joe Johnson, and the one-on-one play was another key. Landry, you know, had him first. Then we went to John. John gave us a little bit. So just searching a little bit in those three positions to give us a defensive stopper or and some offense out of that one spot.